Hello my dear students and friends. In today's session, day 3, we'll see about 1. Developed product, Arduino based quiz console project that I developed some time back. Okay, so today I am not teaching any basics of Arduino, okay, but I'll show you the project and side by side I'll be showing the Arduino code also. Okay, after uploading this video, maybe tomorrow I'll in the description I'll send a link. If you by clicking the link you can download the program and the minimal connection content to execute this particular project by yourself. Okay, so I won't spend more than 5-10 minutes now in this particular session. In this project we have developed a quiz console, okay, a quiz master program. A quiz master program, you know that there is a quiz master. He'll be having a one control button. Then there are 4 different teams, team A, B, C, D. So the each contestant console will be having a button and a bulb. Okay, so whoever after asking the question by the quiz master, whoever know the answer, they'll be pressing first. Okay, after that if any other person presses the button, that should not be in effect. So that is the idea. Okay, these are the part list. Okay, pause the video and see the thing. Anyway, as I told you, now I'll be sending all these things in the description. By clicking that link you can download everything, right? Okay, now this is the thing I developed. Okay, this is the master console. So this is the Arduino, of course. So this is the Arduino. I'll zoom in. So this is the Arduino, Arduino Nano. I told you already I'll be using one and only Arduino Nano, no other Arduino model. Okay, so this is the master button, this is the power on switch, then this is after power on you have to switch on the all the circuits. For that this is the switch. Okay, this button is provided for the for resetting, then only the quiz master can ask, can go for the next question. Okay, so we'll see the next thing. So this is the close-up view of the Arduino Nano. This is the buzzer. Okay, so this is the setup. Okay, so team A, team B, team C, team D. So then this is the master console. The idea is, once the moment the quiz master raises a question, suppose say for example team A know the answer first, so they'll be pressing. Once the team A, this is the console for team A, let it be, once team A press the button, this light will be glowing and simultaneously this bulb also should glow. Okay, after that whether team B, team C, team D presses the button, there should not be any effect. Okay, so after pressing the button this will be glowing, you know, so the quiz master will come to know that, so bulb A is glowing, so team A pressed first, so the team A has to give the answer. Okay, so once they answered the question, whether it is right or wrong, based on the right or wrong, the master will be awarding the mark. So the quiz master has to go for the next question. So these two things will be glowing, you know, at the same time this buzzer also will be making a sound for 0.4 seconds. Okay, again I repeat, team A knows the answer first, so team A pressed it. So this bulb, team A bulb, master bulb and buzzer for 0.5 seconds will be buzzing. Okay, so these things will happen. After that even any other team presses the button, there won't be any effect. Okay, so team A has to answer. After that the quiz master has to go for the second question. So for that, if he presses this one, everything will be reset, then only all the teams are ready for the next question. So this is the logic, right? So I have given the connection, we'll go. Now the console is switched on, master switch is on, team A, B, C, D. Now you see only A is pressed. Now the moment A is pressed, only these two bulbs will glow simultaneously and you'll be hearing a buzzer. Team B. After team B is pressed, you will see even if I press A, B, C, D, there won't be any effect. Okay, then reset. Next thing. Now I will be pressing maybe C, no effect, other D, no effect. Then I will be pressing two buttons simultaneously, but this has been pressed first, maybe. This may be, so now I will be pressing, both simultaneously, okay. So I think probably I would have pressed this first. So even though I press both simultaneously, this is a bit faster, quicker. So this will be glowing, this won't be glowing. So this is how it works. In the meantime, we will see about the program. So this is the program. Okay, so switch for team A, switch for team B, switch for team C, team D. And bulb for team A, bulb for team B, team C, team D. So there are, of course, the switch master reset switch. Okay, so switch 1, 2, 3, 4 and switch master. There are five inputs rather, and four inputs for the four bulbs ABCD, and fifth output for the master bulb, sixth one output for the buzzer. So five inputs and six outputs. Okay, so I am not now you see one thing, you please make a note of it. This switch flag is very important. This is playing a key role. Now by default I didn't mention any number here, that means it is zero. Now you see, let us say switch one is team A, right? So if team A presses, by default switch flag is zero. So if both these conditions are satisfied, then only team A, after pressing team the button by team A, this will be in effect. So LED 1, that is for team A bulb, will be glowing, LED master bulb will be glowing, and buzzer will be hearing. Okay. Simultaneously, you see, after that, before that, the switch flag will be set to 1 now. Initially it was 0, now it is set 1. Okay. Since the switch flag is set at 1, now you see what happens. Simultaneously, let us say, immediately in this, after a split second, let us say team B, switch 2 is on. But switch T may be on, but switch flag must be 0, but it is set as 1 now by team A. So this won't be in effect, this will not be executed. This is the key. Again I repeat, the switch flag is very important as far as this particular program is concerned. How to reset the flag? So there is a master button, no, digital read master. So for the next question, the master switch, the master switch must be pressed. Once the master switch is pressed here, so everything will be reset. Switch flag is reset to 0. All the bulbs, whether it is team A bulb or team B bulb, team C bulb, team D bulb and master bulb, they all will be set at 0. So this is how the program is written. After execution, you see delay 1 is how much? Delay 1 is 3. I said 0.5 seconds, it is not 0.5 seconds, it is 0.3 seconds. So after 0.3 seconds, buzzer will be off. So it's a very simple program, okay. Actually, my PowerPoint is not responding. With that, I'll wind up now, okay. So as I said, tomorrow, I'll be uploading these files in the YouTube link, YouTube description. You can download and you can use it. Thank you.